Okay, so this is a quick tutorial on how to change the tension and also how to attach them to your machine. I'm going to first show that the tension is good and it's properly threaded, and I'm just going to stitch really quickly on this piece of sports twill. So press a foot down, and I'm going to go ahead and go forward, and I guess I'll tie it off, like reverse a little bit. Okay. And I'll snip and snip. So it's stitching really beautifully. I love this. So here is the stitch. Really nice and straight. So it's all good. And I had that on tension set 4. So excuse my nails because they're really horrible. I need to get them done. So the first thing you want to do is take off these pieces. So it's really simple. You just literally unscrew it and take them off piece by piece. And then we can get the thread out of the way as well. So you're going to be left with this pin here or screw, and then this piece here which comes out. And you can put it back in really easily, so don't worry if it's not in there. So it should be in securely and it should be turning this way. And there should be a little bit of tension kind of pulling it down this way. And we can deal with that later. But what you want to do is you want to hook it here in this little slot first. Oops, it's hard to see through the camera. And here. So that'll keep it in place and it should always be like in this position here. So the next piece, actually, before we go into putting the pieces back on, I do want to mention something that you really want to check before you start messing with this. And let me get my light in there. So if you can see this lever here, this is the lever that I use for the presser foot to raise and lower the presser foot. And as you can see, I'm gonna turn this light off because it's burning me. It moves like this. So when the lever is in the down position, this moves freely, that little lever. And then when it's in the up position, it kind of holds that in place. So on the tip there, there's like this little nub and it's out further a lot of times. Right now it's in the pushed in position. But if you don't have a pin here, that's going to be one of your biggest problems. And then if you want your pin to come out, what you can actually do is kind of take like a thin thing and just kind of push it in. And then as you can see, the pin is back out. So you can push the pin in and out freely. So that's what actually affects your tension. And that's why you put all those things in that particular order, is because of that pin and this lever interacting with each other. So going back, oops, to the front of the machine. I'm gonna refocus here. Okay, so now that we're in the front of the machine, the first piece you want to put on is this disc, and it goes in two ways. So you've got the concave and the convex. So you want to have the rounded side this way and make sure that pin doesn't dislodge, or this spring here. You want to push that spring all the way back, put it back in its spot. It's being fussy right now. So once that's in, the next one is its sibling, but you want to put the rounded sides together. So put that in like that, just like with the modern machine tension. You want those to be together. It's harder to see on those because they're kind of tucked away. The next one you want to put in is this guy with this little loop here and has this little crossbar, and there's the other side of it. So you want to put that in there. So that's the first thing that's going to start interacting with that pin on the inside that I was showing you earlier. Then next, you want to take this guy. This one is like a little cup. And it has the crossbar, and then on the top it has the plus and the minus. So you want to make sure the minus is to the left and the plus is to the right. I'm going to put that in there. So that little cup is actually going to hold the spring, which helps with the tension. So then you're gonna put that spring right in there like that. And then once your spring is in place, and also the spring has that crossbar too. I don't know if it matters whether the spring goes this way or this way. I've just been putting it this way with this crossbar going to the left, and it's been working fine. Probably doesn't do anything. So next, you're gonna put this piece on, and it doesn't matter whether the zero is up or down at this point. You just stick it in there. And you can kind of feel that it's pushing on it like that a little bit. So you're gonna take this final piece, and it's got little teeth, and they match the teeth here, but don't start messing with the teeth yet. What you wanna do is kind of push that in with your fingers, and then take this and start screwing it in until they're pretty close to touching, but it's also kind of securely on there, because if you have yours too far out, if you start messing with it, it just pops right off. It's kind of hard to tell whether it's on or off. So just make sure that it's on at least all the way securely. And this may take a few tries. It took me like a good 30 minutes to figure out exactly where I wanted this to be. So this is where you take your string. And right now I have the presser foot up, so there shouldn't be any, or there should be very little tension here. So if I run this through there and there's a lot of tension, I know that it's way too tight. So right now I'm having trouble pushing and pulling this through. So I'm gonna go ahead and set the lever to the down position, take this out, and I'm gonna unscrew this a little bit more. Okay, so now I'm gonna try pulling that through, and there is a little bit of tension going through it. It's kind of like flossing. And I've just got this between those two discs, those first two discs that we put together. That's kind of where you want to put it. And this is not how you thread the machine, of course. This is how you just test the tension. So you're going to keep messing with that and finagling until you get just a tiny bit of tension, like this, the absolute tiniest amount of pull. And that's going to be the zero point. You don't want there to be very much tension on zero at all, if any. A lot of people prefer no tension, where it just kind of falls out once you pull the lever up. I like there to be just a tiny bit of tension, just so that I know that it's actually working. And so you can keep messing with this just a tiny, tiny bit until you get it to the exact amount. So I told you not to worry about the zero being at the top yet. I've just happened to have my zero at the top. This is going to be my zero point, but if your number dial is like on like 8 or 9 or whatever, at that point you can actually turn it until you get yours to the zero. On the inside, it shouldn't let you go far to the right when you do. If you have your zero up here, it shouldn't make you or allow you to go right. And then also, by the time you get to 9, it shouldn't let you go any further to the left. So if it's letting you do that, it might be missing a piece on the inside, or maybe something got worn down, but it should stop you both ways. And if it's not, then you might not have it tight enough, or etc., that kind of thing. So once I set mine there, that's on 4, and then of course you want to test it once you properly thread it through. And that's how you set your bobbin.